Wonder if the gods are watching me.
Step carefully. There's a trap.
Excellent choice. Still breathing, despite everything.
I do enjoy our conversations. What do you need?
Well met.
You wish to speak?
Precious little. But I'm quite certain it can still be found.
With such stimulating company?
Speak.
Can't slow down.
What's on your mind?
What can I do for you?
May the darkness protect you.
touched a bear.
Speak, they burn.
This is my time.
To parley, and he brings a spectator. Twit. Quite ruined by ambush. Now, you are? Rescue? Helpless babes are rescued. I allowed you to assist me. I am Dawn, third son of House Bartol, first rank evoker, and initiate of Graven Hollows. Oh. Oh, no, no, my dear dark gods below, no!
A memory shard. A container onto which brief mental impressions are projected and stored for years at a time.
Far, far longer than I realized. Then my enemies have already found the forge. Which bastard stole my glory? Zargrim? Philro? Consider it mercy, or pest control. Philro was never fully right. We were friends once, three of us working together to find a lost wonder. Until the others grew jealous, began to guard their secrets. Well now, it seems his rather unique mind made itself useful. Clever of you to see through his cipher. A little too clever. I'd rather not lose one rival only to have another sprout in its place. So try to take this as a compliment. Yes?
Be on my way.
offer to parley, and he brings a spec. Now, you are? Rescue, I.
Oh.
A memory shard. A container onto which brief mental impressions of.
Far. Then my enemies have already found the forge. Which bastard stole my glory? Zargrim, consider it. We were. If you didn't, you're a fool. The dead have no use for what's in their pockets. In fact, you've served your purpose now. So allow me to demonstrate.
Let my name be known.
Positioning.
Curious! Thank you.
Is that blood? No, never mind. Have seen everything.
Pushing on.
Spoken with Scrim.
Yes, she is cataloging Kuotuan fertility rituals.
Welcome back. Have you made any new discoveries? I do enjoy a good bargain, if anything in my private collection is to your liking. Very well.
I greet you, child of the sun. How has your search for the mushrooms? These are fine specimens. It will only take me a moment to brew them to proper potency.
Omeluum turns away to prepare the potion, lost in its own musings.
You must drink the entire draught. I can make no promises as to its taste. It will lower the psionic defenses around the lava. If I cannot remove it, I may still be able to tell you more about its origin.
The potion is disgusting beyond description. The only mercy is that it goes down quickly.
Not a drop left. Very good. As the potion influences your mind, you may find yourself acting irrationally. Try and stay focused.
The world loses its edges, its finer boundaries. You are fluid, but trapped like a creature suspended in amber. Colors dance around Omelu, but you stay steady and staring ahead. The tadpole spasms, seizes. It's fighting the potion even harder than you are. Fear pierces your mind like knives of ice. The parasite digs deeper, as if it means to hollow out your skull. A wave of psychic force batters your mind, cruel and calculating. You are nothing to it. You are small. The parasite swells with power, more power than you have ever felt before. It surges and twists, lashing out against that which would dare to intrude. The parasite in your mind quiets, pleased with itself.
Omeluum, are you?
It will lower the psionic. Of course. Return when you are ready.
How is your more personal research? Ripe with magic.
one with the weave.
Defender of the people. At least things have stayed interesting.
I greet you, Sun Child. Yes, although it may be a touch cold by now.
The acidic liquid tightens your throat, burning on the way down. It's a bolt of agony straight to your stomach.
Not a drop left. Very good. As the potion influences your mind...
The world loses its edges, its finer boundaries. You are fluid, but trapped like a creature suspended in amber. A few sparks and colors dance around the tadpole. Fear pierces your mind like knives of ice. The parasite digs deeper, as if it means to hollow out your skull. Cold blades lose their edge. You are stalwart, turning that tide of fear against itself. The parasite swells with power, more power than you have ever felt before. It surges and twists, lashing out against that which would dare to intrude. The parasite in your mind quiets, pleased with itself.
Omeluum, are you well?
That lava is like nothing I have ever observed before. Its power is unsettling. Such an outcome was not in my calculations. There is more to this being than mere stasis. Although, I may have another solution, albeit a temporary one. I possess a ring of mind shielding. It prevents elder brains from noticing my presence. It will not remove the lava, but it will limit its influence, both positive and negative. I would offer it as a gift, but in truth, the ring is priceless. Is there anything you could offer me in turn?
As Amelowan watches your performance, something stirs in his mind, unusual for an illithid. Joy.
Here, it is yours. May it serve you as well as it has served me.
I never thought we'd bargain with an illithid. Let's hope this ring...
Of course, the lava remains. Be ever vigilant of its growth.
Have you spoken with Skriss lately?
Yes. She is cataloging Kuotuan fertility rituals.
The crystal shines only faintly. A memory shard, the wizard had called it. The crystal's glow swells, drawing you into its depths. You are transported. Somewhere deep, loud, and hot as the hells themselves. Within the Underdark's bowels, beyond an ancient stronghold, hovers a giant hammer waiting to fall. An echoing clang, and you're back to yourself, left only with a firm sense of a place, a grand forge.
Forge again. The last journal mentioned a guardian.
Time to press ahead.
Damn it all.
Her condition is familiar. Poison, derived from a wild weed common to the Underdark. She'll need an antidote soon, most likely held by the poisoner.
Dwegor! Slashed me! Grays, don't share. Talking hurts. Leave me, please.
That is, I needed it. Why are you helping me?
Down here?
Tends to be. But I'm nearly good to get on my feet. I thank you for your help, but I've got to get moving. Oh! Gull's garters. Oh, I don't have time for this. My kin need me. Maybe not. But you are. I need you to rescue my kin. We can pay. We're Ironhand Clan, best artificers in Baldur's Gate. We were on an expedition down here when the Dwergar snatched us up. I got away, but not the others. The Greys have them digging out some old ruin across the lake. Just mining for materials. Nothing unusual.
The briefest hesitation, but enough. She's lying.
But our work pays well. Help my clan, and we'll make it worth your while, I swear. Fine. It's complicated, but my clan has trouble back in the city. A blood feud. We were searching for something to turn the tide. That's all I can say. But it's worth a lot to us. Understand? Look, you've done me a good turn and you deserve the truth. But that's as much of it as I can tell, I swear it. If you need to go your own way, I respect that, but still, I'm asking. Thank you. Only wish I could go with you. But here. I nabbed these boots from the Greys when I ran. I'll feel better knowing you're using them to kick some Dwergar ass. I'll mark where I made my escape, and wait here, I suppose. Not much choice, eh?
Well, you done mucking about yet? What a hunt. Maybe you'll find a belt next. Right. I'll mop up here. You get across the Ebon Lake. Find Sergeant Thryn. She'll reward you. Squad of my kin camping in some ruins. Pack of gnome slaves there, too. We're using them for excavation. There's some more ruins Moonrise wants us to make a path to. There's something hidden in them. Something the Absolute wants. Not too sharp, are you? Look for a Dwergar with a sour mug and bare feet.
Vessel wobbles on the lake's murky waters.
What are you doing on Gex Raft? Where's Gek? Who are you? Well, I'll be. You got them? The sergeant's been whining non-stop. What about Gek? Where's he at? More like avoiding the sergeant, I reckon. Come on, let's get you to shore. You're the one telling the sergeant what happened. The rest of you, keep patrolling. I'll be heading back with this one.
You continue forward in silence until the lights of a camp twinkle through the murk.
We've got a welcoming party.
You shithead! Time you showed up! We got trouble!
Spit it out! Sergeant finally choked on true soul Nier's prick!
Drugno! The twat soul caused a rockfall! Trapped tighter than a ring on a fat finger!
You're shitting me. You pay up?
That's the trouble. He's got the gold on him. Sergeant's arm is falling off with all the gnome slaves she's been beating. Who's the whom, Greyman? Another slave for the dig?
Aye. He speaks true. Found the hoon sailing Gek's skiff.
That's so.
You feel the slightest of stirrings in your head. The Duergar is not infected, yet your minds resonate.
I'll be. You're one of them cult freaks. Felt the tingle. Your twat soul chum owes us a load of coin. You want through? Make a donation. I'll be shagged to Shanitar. Shit's looking up. But I'm warning you. That twat soul ain't settled up soon. There'll be hell to pay for the lot of you cult buggers.
She really oozes charm, this one. Perhaps we should spare a thought for the wretches she's enslaved.
Go on.
What are you looking at?
Health.
Dead drow. Publicly displayed. The Duergar are sending a message.
Voice echoes in your mind.
I sense you, true soul. Come to me. Come to Nair. The poison spread.
Nair will die if we leave. Is that a chance you want to take?
Nair's voice fades, but your head still tingles with his anger and fear.
What's a fort like this doing in the Underdark?
Whoever built it, they've let it rot for ages.
If you aren't here to inspect the stonework, then get lost! And if you are, well, I doubt you've got anything useful to say.
How peculiar. Smooth face, cobbled edges. They're a sign. They must be. A sun dweller in these parts. Look here, my topside friend. I need fresh eyes, and I doubt I'll find fresher. As rare as a smile in Sindelrin, you might say. But I've no skill for slaving. I prefer chisel to cane. But these learned eyes reach their limits, and so I must humbly request yours. The rock, the rubble, all of it, if I may be so bold. Take a look, tell me what you see, and be thorough.
You recall the tale of a Sharan fortress armed with impenetrable adamantine, a metal created by a gnomish mage. There were also whispers of the gnome's secret project, an invincible guardian, though its existence was never proven.
What do you think? How fascinating. I told my kinfolk that book learning has its benefits. A crafty gnome helping forge a fortress that would last an eon. Mythic metal atop stone hewn by the devoted. That's to say nothing of this tale of an invulnerable protector. It's unfortunate the Sharan's successors found no proof. Doesn't explain this infernal plate I found, though. Here. Take it. Perhaps you'll be able to figure out why it's here.
But my work has only begun. There is more still to find. I must get to it. Well, let's see what you've got. Let's solve them.
History is carved in stone and burned in brick.
The most interesting secrets are always lurking just under the surface.
Tired! Sleep!
Rest, little one. But do not take long. I feel his shadow. I heard his name whispered. The rock shivers from the sound. The Ketherick Thorm.
Ketherick Thorm, a familiar name. Halsin mentioned his stronghold deep underground.
Mighty elf, cloaked in darkness. 10 masters ago, and 10 more. But I remember. There was the work, and the blood. There was the Thorm's army. There was the Hellbeast that broke them. The Ketherick Thorm's name faded into stone until the Nier came. I outlived my mother and her mother's mother. And many mothers beyond. Blessed to see many live, cursed to see many die. I saw tusks and flesh, smelled fire and eggs. It came with the mask men, crashing and smashing. I know not, so I say not. Yet I hear his name again, said by the shadows.
Afraid. Afraid of Thorm.
Do not think on it.
Oh, are those two still talking?
Sharp as ever. This better be good.
At the skeletons, you realize they are all clad in the same dark armor.
Look at those uniforms. They must have belonged to some kind of sect.
Fabrics, you recognize the unmistakable symbol of Shar, the Dark Lady.
Maybe. But if whatever managed to murder a group of Sharans is still around, you'd better watch our step.
Remnants of battle. This is the stronghold Halsin mentioned.
You, grab a cane and whip these Drugnin beasts into shape. That rubble needs clearing, and my patience is hanging on by an arse whisker. Damn right I do. Getting cramps in my arm, trying to whip the Drugnin beasts back to work. Now get to the caning, for I thrash you instead. You got no need to know, and I got no need to tell. So get to caning, or to leaving. Fine. Look at this. Adamantine. Stuff's no joke. Stronger than steel, rarer than mithril. It ain't mined. It's made. There's an adamantine forge back there, sure as shitting. Don't get any smart ideas. That forge is clan property. But get the beasts moving and I'll toss some coin your way. Go on then. Light a fire under the buggers.
The adamantine forge.
No more pain. No more work. All must die. All right. We will work. We will do as we're told. We will clear the way.
Droog, yes! Yeah. Not enough caning for my tastes, but you got the job done. I almost feel bad about this. Adamantine is precious, Jarg, and I'm not the sharing type. Bloody Rose, they have lost it. Put him down!
Deck tall! feel.
Swift and lethal. I will not know failure.
I know just what to do.
It shall be done.
Victory awaits. This is your end.
interesting times.
Duergar can't hurt anymore. We'll wait until it's safe to leave.
Not much use for this slag. Nice speckles, though. I'm done. I can't wait.
And here I go.
Action, not reaction. Securing.
No time to rest. Light on my feet. Something's off. Pure shadow. Around. Inside.
I'd better be careful not to trigger that thing.
Trap.
careful not to trigger that thing. Caution is warranted here. Thank you.
enough waiting. I crave blood.
Got a long road ahead. Well, that ends not as bad as it could have.
Quake of some sort, that.
Well met. I am a magical projection of Gale of Waterdeep, and if you see this manifestation, that means I have prematurely perished. However, for reasons that cannot be disclosed, It is of vital importance that my death be remedied at your earliest convenience. You may rest assured that I do not speak out of self-preservation alone. Many lives depend on my return to the living within the span of 2 days. I trust I've made myself clear. I have upon my deceased person a magical item that can accomplish my return. But such is the value and rarity that it is protected by a multi-layered security protocol. I will now explain the protocol. Step one is to retrieve from my person a pouch I wear over my heart. Next, you must unthread the purple seam that seals it in a counterclockwise fashion. Do not touch any other colored strand. Inside the pouch, you will find a folded letter and a tiny flute. Unfold the letter and note the markings in the top and bottom corners. These are the notes you will need to play. Starting from the bottom right, play the notes in correct order, clockwise this time. Upon completion of the tune, a magma method will appear, which will pose the following question. Iskcha Chisnaga. This is Ignan for what is my name? The answer is Kasitrak Ash. Pronounce the name correctly, and the mephit will breathe on the letter. Stay clear, because the little scamp can melt metal. Words will now appear on the letter's surface, effectively turning the letter into a scroll of true resurrection. Use it to bring me back to life. I think ingenious is the word you're looking for. Now, repeat my instructions back to me, please. In that case, this will be an easy exercise. Step one. And next. Right. You then have access to the letter and the flute. Go on. Remember to play them clockwise. And after that?
I think it's the one ending in Osh. Easy mistake.
Listen to your friend. It's Kasi Trach Ash. And pay attention to the Trach part. Yeah, back of the throat. And so we have gone through the necessary steps again. Let's hope practice makes perfect in the end. Best of luck with the protocol. May my cold, dead hands soon be refilled with the warmth of life so they can shake yours in gratitude.
Death can't have me. Not yet. My word, you did it!
Oh, it's good to be alive. My hands are still cold, so that handshake will have to wait, but in the meantime, thank you.
Quite. And I must say, I'm glad you've taken my plight to heart. I see my trust in you was most excellently placed. Now, I believe adventure awaits. Or misadventure, perhaps. Shall we? Nothing would give me greater pleasure. What's the subject of the day?
The instructions were easy enough, weren't they? If slightly elaborate.
I find that a healthy amount of theatrics, a voice from the beyond, a magic flute, a friendly, if highly combustible magma mephit, tends to make for a more compelling case. If nothing else, I'm sure I piqued your curiosity.
time wasted. Battle awaits. Graceful, powerful. I could ask no more of a crossbow. Are the Dwaegar so capable?
Be wary. This place is trapped.
keeping pace. What now? With haste.
Come, all who are weary. Sleep and forget.
You ain't been the same since that rock slide.
Swift as my feet can carry me. Tracks there, or footprints. That's worth a look. What happened here? It's hard to make any sense of this mess.
The pride of the gate.
What's all this?
Something shady was going on here.
Such a mess. What happened here, I can't fathom.
It's hard to make any sense of this mess.
faint voice echoes in your mind.
I sense you, true soul. Come to me. Come too near. The poison spread.
You hear him too, don't you? Nier is not long for this world unless we get him out of there.
Nier's voice fades, but your head still tingles with his anger and fear.
been the same since that rock slide.
Ain't been the same.